Hello friends, this is Devagota and thank you for joining Interview Console. In this video, I am going to talk about one more topic in C sharp journey, that is nothing but list. So in this video, we will learn how to work with list collections class. Okay. So that is available in generic collections. So now let's start it. Before going to start, first of all, I want to say something. If you did not subscribe my YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel and don't hit this bell icon, because if you will hit this bell icon, you will get notification when I will upload new video. Okay, so now first of all, as we know that in C sharp collections there are an array list class also is there. Okay, but this class, in this session we will learn list class. Okay, so this class is available in system.collections.generic namespace. So first we need to understand what is list class. Okay, so now understand the list class. So the list class is nothing but it is similar to array list class, but here the type safety is there. So the list is nothing but here type collection is the same as array list, except that list P is nothing but type is a generic collection, whereas array list is a non-generic collection. Okay, so the list of P class in .NET represents a strongly typed list of objects that can be accessed by index. Okay, so some of the most common used popular method I will available here. So I am going to use that method and with the help of very simple example, so you can understand easily. Okay, so some methods add range, clear, contains, copy to, index of, last index of, reverse, sort, remove all. Okay, so some of the properties like count, capacity, like that. So there are so many methods, but I am going to discuss some of the most commonly used methods available here. So now understand with the help of example. Before going to work with list, I want to remind you the array list class so you can understand better. If you did not watch my previous video on array list, then please watch that video, array list. Okay, I think that is the part 1 of the collections. So now understand. So this is my array list class here. So array list, I have created a list variable here. So I have worked on that. Okay, so you can see here in the array list, we can insert any type of value here, integer, character, float, and double, and here string, like that we can insert any value. If I want to access this value, we can access. Okay, so I want to show you the output. So you can rewind this code. Press F5 key. So 11p interview 44.5. You can see the output here. So initial capacity is 0. 11p for interview 44.5. 10.5. Okay, so like that we can insert any type of value here. So now I am going to work with list collection class here. So first of all, we need to create a main method here. Okay, so before going to work with list class, I want to tell you that is available in system.collections.namespace. So don't forget to use that namespace here. Okay friend, if you will not use this namespace, you will get error. Suppose if I will use like that, it will not available. Okay, it is a capacity, it is giving error. Suppose lst equal to new list, so it is giving error. Okay, but if I will use this namespace, error will go on. Okay, there is no error, but we need to define the type. So suppose I am going to use integer type here. So integer. Okay, if I will not use namespace here, then I will get error. Okay, so you can see the error. So now I am going to work with some method here. So first method I am going to use an add method. Okay, so lst dot add. Suppose I am going to insert integer value. So suppose first value will be my 2. Okay. So second value will be 4. And same as I want to give 2 more value here. Suppose 6 and here. Okay friend, so I want to access that value and print the output. So for each int I in lst. Okay friend, so console dot write line, I want to print here I, and after that console dot read line. So you can see the output. So first, before going to run this class, we need to set the path here. So list for, okay, so this is list for here. Now run this, press F5 key, and now you can see the output 4, 2, 4, 6, 5. Okay, so like that we can work with array, sorry, list class. Okay, so now if I will use here lst.clear method, then we can see the output here only 2 values are available. Now here only 2 values are here, 6 and 5, but above value are not available because that value I have cleared or deleted. Okay, by using the clear method. Okay, to comment this, now I am going to work with another method. Suppose I want to show, so console.writeline contains method. Okay, so lst.contains, so it is asking us int item is nothing but these items. Okay, so I want to define, so it will return true and false value. Okay, so suppose I am inserting here 7 is not there. After that console.writeline, because I want in the next line, 7 is not there, but it will give output false. Okay, so we can see here output is false, but if I will enter here 6, then press F5 and see the output, now it is true. Okay, so one more method I am going to use here. So contains index of, suppose console.writeline lst.index of. Okay, now see the what it is asking, integer item. So it will tell us the index. Okay, so what it index of method, what it will do, it will tell the index. Suppose 0, 1, 2, 3. We have 4 items. As we know that our array list, array always start from 0. So first item index position will be 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So 5 is available at the 3 position. So it will print 5 here. So what it will print here? The index position. Index position of 5 is, so I am writing here index position of 5 is, now you can see the output, it will give us we need to put some plus. So now it is done. Now run this class. Now you can see index position of 5 is 3. Like that we can use. So next method I am going to use here, copy that method and paste. Suppose I am going to use here last index of. Okay, so last. So now see the output. What it is asking to us, it is bool value. So it will return bool. Okay friends. So bool value. But we need to define some value here, suppose 3. Okay. So last index of 3. But if suppose I have only one value here, 3. 3 is not available here. Okay. So I am not going to, I don't want to print the value of index of 3. But I have 2, 4, 6. Suppose I have 4. So I want to print the 4. Now see the output. It will print 1 because it is available at 1. Okay. Index position is 1. But I want to show you again. So index position of 4. Here 4. But if I will insert one more lst dot add, suppose I have one more 4 value here, we can insert duplicate value, no problem. But now because it will return, it will give us the output as last index of 4. So we have first and second means last. So this is my first and this is my last value 4. Okay, these two items we have. Okay, so it will return last index of 4 is 0, 1, 2 and 3. So it will return 3. So I am commenting here 3 and here also. Now it will return index of 5 equal to, because 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So now it will return 4. Okay, so now see the output. Index position of 5 is 4 and index position of 4 is 3. So like that we can work on this method. So now suppose I want to reverse that value. So first run this. Now it is not in the sorted form. 2, 4, 6, 5 is in the last. Okay. So it is not in the sorted form. So I want to sort this value. Suppose if lst dot sort. Now you can see the output will be in the sorted form. So you can see 2, 4, 4, 5, 6. Now it is available in sorted form. So one more method I am going to use here. Suppose if I will use remove method. Okay, remove. Suppose I am going to use here remove. So lst dot remove. Okay, remove. But we need to define here value. Suppose which item we want to remove. Okay, so it is asking int item, not index. Okay, so we need to define item value here. Suppose I want to remove 4, but here 2 4 is available. So if I will define as a 4, so it will remove both 4. Okay, so you can see the output. But now here it is, I am not going to print here because I want to show you the this method. Okay, so remove, see the output. Okay, so first is not available but second is available. Okay, suppose if I want to remove here now 2. Okay, 2, now you can see the output, 2 is not available in this list. Okay friends, so like that we can work with remove method. But one more method is here, remove add and remove all. Suppose remove add, it will ask to us the index position of list. Okay, but here it will ask value, but here it will ask index position. Index position, suppose I want to give 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, suppose 3 and it is 2. 6 is available at 2, so I am given 2. Okay, so now 6 is not available in the list. I want to comment this and I want to use this method. So remove at, now run this class, remove at method and see the output. 2, 4, 4, 5, but 6 is not available because it is available at the index position of 2. Okay, 6 is available at the index position of 2, that's why it is not available. Okay, one more method here, similar, that is nothing but remove all. Okay, so I am going to use here the remove all method. So I want to comment this method. Okay, this method I want to close. first run this class and see the output here. 244, 244, 56 is in the formatted. That means sort, because we are using the sort method. But before printing, I want to use one method that is nothing but lst dot word method. I want to use here remove all. Okay, friends. So remove all here. Now see the output. Remove all. What it is asking? It is asking remove all. Predicate, integer, and match. So remove all the elements that match the condition defined by the specified predicate. Okay. So like that we can work this method. Okay. Suppose I want to, I have not used any method property here. So I want to show you the property lst dot suppose count. Okay. Count property. I want to discuss here. Count. Now see the output here. It is printing 5. Okay, friends. So it is printing 5 because I have 5 elements here. 2, 4, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 elements are there. So that's why it is returning 5. Contains method, it is returning true because of 6 is available in this list. Okay, friends, so this method I want to stop this. Okay, so stop this and then yeah. Okay, friends, so now see the output. I want to give some space here, so new line. Now see the output, it is printing 5. Okay, friends, so like that we can work with the count capacity. So many methods are there. So this is all about list class in C sharp generic collection. So I hope you got some knowledge, and in the my playlist you have you can see the most important questions are also there. C sharp interview program also is there. SQL Server interview questions there. Yes, we don't need interview questions. Okay, so Java interview question also is there, but don't miss to watch this C sharp logical program. It is the most important for the fresher purpose. And this is also .NET system test, machine run test interview also is there, and MVC in the current trend is MVC. So I am going to work on this MVC. So I will upload more videos on this. So don't miss my any videos and subscribe my YouTube channel. So then I will upload new video. You will get notification for that. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe our YouTube channel Interview Gods. This is my Facebook page. Please like my Facebook page. And this code is available in this blog. I will give you the link in the description box of this video. I think this is the, you will get the, this code by typing DK93. Okay, friends. So thank you. I hope you will enjoy this video. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel. And all the best, guys. Keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.